Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. Let's solve this percent mixture problem using two variables. It can also be solved using one variable, and I did this problem on another video using only one variable. But if you know how to do a system of equations, solve a system of equations with two variables, then you can also do this problem using two variables. So what do we have? We have a chemist that has a 21% salt solution and a 15% salt solution. How many quarts of each should be used to produce 60 quarts of a 19% salt solution? So what it's saying is this chemist has couple different solutions. They have a 21% salt solution. This means the strength is 21%. 21% of the solution is pure salt. And they also had a 15% solution. And they want to mix these together to get a strength somewhere in between. So I'll say here's the in-between one, and that would be 19%. That's in between 15 and 21. Not exactly in between, just somewhere in between, right? So they're trying to end up with a 19% solution. And how many quarts of that 19% solution? We want to end up with 16 quarts of the 19% solution. So I want to end up with 60 quarts of a 19% solution. All right, underneath each of these, I like to write my percentage in terms of a decimal. So I know that 21% can be written as 0.21, 15 is 0.15, and 19% is 0.19. Now, I don't know how many quarts of each solution I'm going to mix together. That's the question. How many quarts of each solution should be used? So there's two things I don't know, and that lets us use two variables. So how about if I call the first solution, I'm going to use x quarts, and in the second solution, I'm going to use y quarts. I know the amount of solution together has to add up to 60, so that gives me one equation, x plus y equals 60, is one equation, right? So I'm pouring x quarts plus y quarts, and I end up with 60 quarts. That has nothing to do with how much salt is in there. It's just the amount of water that happens to have salt in it. Right? So this is one equation. I'm going to sort of set it off to the side here. Now I want to talk about the amount of salt in each of these solutions. Well, if it's a 21% salt solution, what it means is that 21% of what's in there is pure salt. So the pure salt in this first vat is 20.21x. The amount of salt, of pure salt, in the second solution is 0.15y, and the amount of salt in the final solution is 0.19 times 60. Now, if you pour these two solutions together in here, the amount of salt that were in the two solutions, the pure salt of each, is the same as the pure salt in the final solution. So this is the other equation. So I have a system of equations. I have 0.21x plus 0.15y equals 0.19 times 60, and I also have x plus y equals 60. Now, usually people prefer to work without decimals. So you can do that by taking this first equation and modifying it just a little bit, multiplying both sides of the equation by 100, right? And when you do that, you have 100 times 0.21 is 21x. 100 times 0.15, that'll give you the 15y. And 100 times 0.19 is 19 times 60. Now, you do not need to, I mean, actually, you cannot multiply 100 twice. In other words, you don't multiply the 0.15 times 100 and also the y times 100. That would be multiplying by 10,000. Same thing over here. You just multiply the 100 times the 0.19 first, and you still have to multiply that by 60. So here are my two equations, right? Here's the other equation. And so I'm going to go on to the next page and put these down. So here are the two equations, and I could go ahead and do 19 times 60 right here, right? I could simplify that. And when you have two equations and two unknowns, you have a system like this, you could either use the substitution method or you could use the addition and elimination method. Now, remember how in the previous page here, I multiplied by 100? You could always multiply both sides of an equation by something or divide both sides of the equation by something. There's something I noticed about this equation. You didn't have to notice this, but I noticed that all the terms on both sides have a factor of 3. So I'm going to make this arithmetic a little bit easier. I'm going to divide both sides of the equation by 3. I'm going to get easier numbers to work with. I always like to work with easier numbers. This is an option for you. You don't need to do this. So this would become 7x plus 5y equals, and then what's going on over here? The 3 goes into the 60, 20. So now I just have 19 times 20. Well, let's see. 19 times 2 is 38, and I have a 0. So now I've got these two equations. 7x plus 5y equals 380, and I have x plus y equals 60. And again, at this point, you could use substitution to solve it, or you can use the addition elimination method. I'm going to go ahead and do the addition method. All right, so we have x plus y equals 60. And I want to either eliminate the x values or the y values. Okay, I'd rather multiply by 7 than 5, so I'm going to multiply, I'm sorry, I'd rather multiply by 5 than 7. So I'm going to take the second equation and multiply by negative 5 on both sides of the equation, because that'll have a negative 5y. Okay? And the y's will cancel out. So what does this give me for my two new equations? The first one just stays the same, right? 7x plus 5y equals 380. And the next one is negative 5x minus 5y and negative 300. Remember to multiply both sides of the equation by that negative 5. All right, so on the left side, all I have when I'm adding what's on the left side together is 2x. And on the right side, I have 80. Just divide both sides by 2, and we've got 40. And as I said, you could use any method you want to solve these original two systems of equation. You will get x equals 40. In fact, if you want to not even multiply both sides by 100, keep everything with decimals, 0.21x plus 0.15y equals 0.19 times 60. Just work the whole problem out using decimals, using the addition elimination method or the substitution method, you will still get x equals 40. So I know that x equals 40. Now, if x equals 40, I can go back up to one of my original equations and figure out y. And I think the easiest one would be, of course, to use this equation. If you put in 40 for x, 40 plus what would equal 60? Well, y would be 20. So now I know my x and my y. So let's go back and look at what those stood for. Right. Well, X stood for how many quarts of the 21% solution I was going to use, and Y, how many quarts of the 15% solution. And of course, if we had 40 plus 20, that does add up to 60, so that part makes sense. Now we want to make sure the amount of salt in each really is the same. So now we need to check that part. Now we're going to check it. Here's our original problem, and this was our setup, putting an X and Y, and we just found out that x is 40 and y is 20. We want to make sure that's really true. So if x is 40, I'm just going to put in 40 for x and 20 for y here. So let's do that. Okay, so we could see that yes, if we're adding 40 quarts plus 20 quarts, I do end up with 60 quarts. The next thing is to see if the amount of salt, of pure salt, in each of these solutions is the same as the amount of pure salt in the final solution. So, what would be the pure salt in each of these two? Well, this would be 0.21 times 40. Now, you could do that any way you want to figure out what number that is, or you could use a calculator, you can, get out a piece of scratch paper and figure out, do it in your head, whatever, but you will get 8.4. So there are 8.4 quarts of pure salt in this solution. And in the second solution, 0.15 times 20, there are 3 quarts of pure salt. So I know that in the final solution, you should have the same amount of salt. Well, what's 8.4 times plus 3? That's 11.4 quarts of pure salt. And is that the same as the amount? So that's the question. Is that the same as the amount of pure salt? If I have a 19% solution, 60 gallons of a 19% solution, I'm sorry, 60 quarts of a 19% solution. And yes, 0.19 times 60 is also 11.4. So yeah, it does check. So now all we have to do is answer the question. So here's our final answer to this problem. Use 40 quarts of the 21% salt solution and 20 quarts of the 15% salt solution. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.